the signs of death. Let me give you more visual reality. Exactly when you leave the body, your individual soul will leave from this one layer to another layer. This is the way it will move. You can see that physical layer. Please understand. One thing I wanted you all to know, don't be frightened by the way I am describing it. And just understand, this is fact, and we need to get into it to get out of it. By getting frightened, you are not going to solve the issue. And same way, by not knowing this fact, you are not going to solve the issue. Now, by not knowing what is going to happen during death, don't think you are going to solve that issue. And same way, by getting frightened also, you are not going to solve that issue. So, listen, then we will work on the solution. First layer, the physical body, from there, your individual consciousness will move to the next layer, the breathing pattern. That was the time your whole skin will release kind of a poison, like scorpion venom. The quality of the chemical which will be released by your skin to handle the consciousness separating will be almost like a scorpion venom. So it's like a whole body will be injected by the scorpion venom. If you are bitten by a scorpion, after a few minutes that whole area will become frozen. Have you seen? It will become like a wood, solid. Any doctors? You understand what I am saying? Have you treated those patients? No. US doctors. Okay. All right. Anyway, let me describe, understand this. So, basically, your whole, it's like a peeling your skin. The separation of your consciousness in the skin starts happening. That's the first step in the death. Then, your whole consciousness gets centered on the breathing. That's why that feeling like asthma or wheezing. When that settles down, your consciousness moves to your mind. Tremendous suffering about you not living your life completely. You not actualizing yourself. But by the time you are medically dead. Only two layers your body will be active. By the time you go to the mental layer, the third component of you, you will be declared as medically dead, clinically dead by doctors. But after you are declared clinically dead, around 42 minutes you take completely to settle down and take another one body. In that 42 minute, any engram inside is very strong, can get you back to the life. Those people only we call people who had near-death experience, who left this two layer, declared as medically dead, but came back due to some other patterns in the deeper layers. I have seen a lady, 3 times came back to life. Second time, people were shocked because first time they did not check with the doctor. First time when the breathing has stopped, they decided she is dead and organized everything. And she got up and sat after 2 hours. So second time they made sure the doctor comes and tests, certifies. Anyhow. Second time they made sure that doctor checks the lady, but again she came back after 1.5 days. Third time, not really. Third time, they kept her body for 3 days. They were not ready to believe she is dead. But finally, they took her body to the cremation ground. They even arranged the whole thing. Before putting the fire, the son wants to check her once. And she called, Amma, 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 3 times, and she got up and sat. Really? But in the Indian villages, there is a tradition, once you go to the cremation ground, you can't come back to the house. Really? So they built a house for her near the cremation ground and lived. I have seen her during my school days. And my own yoga guru, Yogananda Puri, of course this is yogic power, he had 47 heart attack. Doctors are not ready to believe he is going to die by heart attack. The day before his death, he has performed a feat of tying the rope in his chest and making it burst just through breathing. He tied iron rope, please understand, not ordinary rope, iron rope on his chest. He just completely exhaled and tied that and inhaled, and that rope broke to pieces. The power of the pranayama. But he was too old at that time. Then he was taken to hospital because he complained chest pain. During the ECG, I think 3 or 4 days they kept him in the under the monitor. They said 47 times heart stopped completely. Full heart attack happened. 47 times he had heart attack, but he did not die. So doctors were shocked. They said, he is not the guy who is going to die. Please take him to home. Even if he has heart attack, his heart stops, don't think he is dead. They sent him back to the house, and few days he was resting in the house. At least 2 times pulse rate completely stopped, pulse stopped, and body became cold, and again he came back to life. Finally he himself said, by tomorrow evening, bury me. And then he stopped his pulse, but body never became cold. So none of the disciples wants to bury him. Even I did not want to bury him. I said, no question of burying. The body is not smelling. Body is not signs of death. So you should not bury. We all have decided we will not bury. We will wait and maintain the body. After the decision, next day, I went to a pilgrimage place. I know he is the embodiment of Patanjali. So I went to Rameshwaram, where Patanjali's samadhi is there, to pray, please come back to life. I felt if I go and pray there and bring that sacred water from that 21 Tirthas in Rameshwaram. Any of you been to Rameshwaram temple? All of you should know that temple belongs to Madhuri Vadinam. My predecessors have voluntarily handed over. Still we have records that temple, when it was handed over to the government, it owned 300 ton gold. Still the treasury is there. I don't know how much of gold is still left. But when we handed over the temple back to the government, voluntarily, one of my predecessors was Rameshwaram temple. One of my predecessors, when he was coronated as a head of the Madurai Adhinam, he was a minor. So he could not run. So government voluntarily he handed over both the temples to government saying that after he becomes major, he will take it back, but he never took it back again. So when he handed over, the documents were prepared, what all has been handed over. So in that 300 ton gold, that time one sovereign gold was, tola is some Indian unit, gold was 1 rupee. One tola is how many? 10 grams. That was 1 rupee. So he said, the record says 300 ton gold was handed over. Still we have the records. 1 ton is 1000 kilogram. 300 ton is 300,000 kilograms. Of course, it was, Madhuri Adhinam was the official. So Madhuri Adhinam was the Rajaguru, means head of the chief guru, you call it. So the whole king's treasury was divided into four: army part, civilians part, king's part, and religious part. The religious part was owned by Adhinam. Army part was owned by the commander. Civilians part was owned by the teachers who used to teach and conduct rituals those days. Not the temple rituals, the marriage, all those ceremonies. They are called Purohits. And the king's part was owned by king. That was the way the wealth was shared in those days. So this was 1/4 of the Ramanathapuram kingdom's wealth. Understand the richness. So I went to Rameshwaram, to this temple only. But when I went to Rameshwaram, he had 14 sons. Raghupati Yogi had 14 sons before taking up sannyas. He was married, two wives. One wife passed away, second wife lived. She is still alive. This is the temple. And see, in that 14 sons, two sons were against him. They don't trust his yogic powers and all that. They don't believe him. They took the decision and buried him. They fought with others. Usually these bad fellows will be very aggressive, na, and powerful. When I was out, they did it. When I went to Rameshwaram to pray and bring that water to sprinkle on his body, they buried it. So I could not do anything. When I came back, as per the religious ceremony, you cannot dig out the body which is cremated. So I have to tolerate and left it. Otherwise, I don't believe he is dead. He was buried when he was alive. Jiva Samadhi. So this, in these seven layers, if you move beyond two layers, you are medically dead. You are declared medically dead. But you are not dead. The third layer you go through, intense confusion and guilt of not living your life. If you don't actualize yourself, that space will be hell for you. Not living your life. And the fourth layer, etheric body, that is where all the pains are stored, where you see demons, rakshasas. So in each of these layers, you carry certain patterns and engrams which we need to break and free. If these engrams and patterns are not broken, death is going to be, as I described now, tremendous suffering. If these patterns are broken and destroyed now itself, death is going to be like a butter, the knife moving through the butter. Understand? What my presence did to that person, the second death, the same thing I am reproducing on all of you now itself through this technology, through this method. So I promise, when I say I mean, I promise painless death for all of you. Of course, you may not be able to legally hold me responsible for this word, because I will be able to come back after death. But I tell you, spiritually, neither I have death nor you have death. You can and you will meet me after you leave the body. And if I have not fulfilled my word, you can hold me responsible at that time. And I tell you, I will fulfill my word. I am very clear about what I am uttering. I already said, Kala Bhairava, he is the witness, let his presence be there. This whole science got downloaded into my system to help the people to have painless, peaceful death and restful awareness in the end of the death. That is what we call enlightenment. But when I started teaching this science to people, I discovered not only the quality of death, even the quality of life after this program has started drastically increasing. See, when you don't have patterns and engrams, your life also develops, increases the quality. That's when I started teaching this program to youngsters. I started telling, science of death is not for the people only who are about to die. It is for the people who are about to live. Otherwise, you see, human mind, when you are young, you always feel, all this meditation, enlightenment, let us do it in the old age. This is not the time for it. At that time, yoga, meditation, this all we should have done it in young age. Oh, how can we do it now? That's human mind. That is human mind. So it is straight away how they do the bypass surgery and put pacemaker, same way. These 4 days I'm going to do a conscious surgery on you and put pacemaker. When the temperature of death starts happening in you, usually when the death is supposed to happen, first thing that skin will release that scorpion venom kind of a chemical. That is when the death temperature starts happening. The moment it happens, this whole experience will open up in you. Vivekananda says very beautifully, even once, if you have a conscious experience during the death, it automatically opens up and leads you to enlightenment. So in these 4 days, at least one strong conscious Kundalini experience I'll insert into your system. So whenever the death pain opens up, it may be any time, immediately this experience will open up automatically like a pop-up and lead you to enlightenment without any pain and peacefully into the restful awareness.